Renewable energy sources are widely applauded as the next step in the quest for clean energy, but there is a dark side to renewables when it comes to environmental, safety, and human rights issues, issues that create pollution, serious safety hazards, habitat destruction, and land degradation. Could it be that in the push toward clean energy and reduction of greenhouse gases, green is actually fading to black? Renewable energy sources, including wind turbines and batteries for electric cars, rely on the mining of rare earth minerals. Depending on the source one consults, China controls from 85% to 95% of global rare earth production. This video shows sludge contaminated from rare earth and coal mining being pumped into a 10-kilometer toxic Chinese lake. Further, Chinese rare earth mines have polluted water and farmlands to the extent that a study found that 19 of 85 Chinese tea products were contaminated by rare earth metals. Due to their low concentration in the earth, rare earth elements must be mined with open pits, which is obviously very destructive to the environment. In addition, as this image shows, huge pits must be dug for tailings, the radioactive slurry almost always produced in rare earth mining. The rare earth mineral industry produces 5 times more waste gas than all the miners and oil refiners in the U.S. and produces 13 billion meters of gas and 25 million tons of wastewater laden with carcinogenic metals. To further illustrate this issue, let's look more closely at one of the most visible trends underway these days. Electric cars powered by motors that use energy stored in rechargeable batteries. These green vehicles are touted as being more efficient than cars with internal combustion engines that run on hydrocarbons. But behind the scenes of this growing phenomenon is a much darker story, one featuring child labor, abusive working conditions, and severe pollution. Electric cars depend on lithium-ion batteries, which also power billions of smartphones and other high-tech devices across the globe. These vehicles and the batteries they rely on are dependent on rare earth minerals, primarily cobalt and graphite, both of them highly polluting and often hazardous to mine. Demand for cobalt batteries has grown tremendously, an increase attributed to electric vehicles, which are being manufactured by a growing number of companies, from Tesla to GM. Yet, whereas a smartphone uses 5 to 10 grams of refined cobalt, a single car battery contains up to 15,000 grams. A new study by research firm Arthur D. Little determined that battery-powered electric vehicles generate more than 3 times as much human toxicity as an equivalent internal combustion engine vehicle. This is because of human exposure to heavy metals, including cobalt, graphite, and nickel. More than half the world's cobalt comes from the Democratic Republic of the Congo in Central Africa, a poor and troubled country where foreign exploitation of natural resources has long been practiced. Anywhere from 110,000 to 150,000 local miners, many of them children as young as 7 years old, use rudimentary hand tools to scavenge and dig out rocks containing cobalt from pits and tunnels deep underground with little or no protective gear or safety oversight. Continued exposure to cobalt dust can cause potentially fatal lung disease. These working conditions and health risks have raised global concerns about human rights violations. The supply chain continues. Congo Dongfang Mining International, a subsidiary of a large Chinese maker of cobalt products, mines and sends the cobalt to China, where it is further processed and then sold to battery component manufacturers. Lithium iron batteries also use some amount of graphite, a mineral primarily mined in China that produces significant industrial air and water pollution. Parts of China experience graphite rain, rainwater blackened by airborne graphite powder. Pollution from the mining process has led to a variety of health issues, especially respiratory problems. Despite these issues, and even as more consumers, businesses, and industries recognize the benefits of driving clean, natural gas-powered vehicles, the U.S. government has created an unlevel playing field when it comes to policies, such as vehicle and fuel tax credits and research and development funding, decidedly favoring electric vehicles over natural gas vehicles. Now let's look at wind power, also considered environmentally friendly. Yet modern wind turbines also depend on the mining of rare earth elements, which, as we've seen, is certainly not good for the environment. Nor are wind turbines bird friendly, killing more than 600,000 birds per year. Worse, raptors such as bald eagles and golden eagles are extremely vulnerable to wind turbines. More than 2,000 golden eagles have been documented as killed at the Altamont Wind Energy Project in California. Wind turbines are an even greater threat to bats. Spinning turbines create low pressure zones near the tips of the blades. When a bat flies into these areas, the bat's lungs are higher pressured than the surrounding air. The resulting expansion can rupture tiny vessels around the lungs, effectively causing the bat's lungs to explode. More than 600,000 bats were reported killed from wind turbines during 2012. Some sources, however, place the death count as high as 900,000. In stark contrast to the mining of rare earth minerals, natural gas and oil are produced under strict industry guidelines and protocols, along with comprehensive international, federal, and local and state regulations designed to ensure that operations are safe, ethical, and respect the environment, minimizing air, water, and noise pollution. What about solar? Often portrayed as the poster child for green, renewable energy, solar also poses significant, little publicized environmental risks. Depending on location, large-scale solar facilities can cause land degradation and habitat loss. Because solar panels blanket the land, there is little opportunity for solar farms to share land with agriculture. This NASA photo shows the California's massive 550-megawatt Topaz solar farm. At 9.5 acres, the farm is one-third the size of Manhattan and the same size as 4,598 football fields. The oil and gas industry, on the other hand, has found and is continuing to develop ways to use fewer resources, less land, and greater automation to produce, refine, and transport increasingly clean energy, such as natural gas, for consumers, all with accountability, transparency, and in collaboration with local, state, and federal regulations. New efficiencies in hydrocarbon production have greatly reduced the impact on agriculture and farming operations. That's progress. As the world continues on a path of going green, what may appear obvious on the surface is not the full picture when it comes to renewables. Some of the seemingly best hydrocarbon alternatives may in fact have a backstory that in many ways is returning us to a black, dark world where pollution and unsafe working conditions are once again emerging. And that's turning back the clock on progress.